shoulders like a gnaw as the first drum rolled through the blasted town. The god of schemes stayed his wire-wrapped fist from impaling its last dozen inhabitants. The second drum drew the father of vampires from the ravaged town. He loomed over Aegon with rapt attention. But the final strum drew forth a single tear from the Lord of Brutality's eye. "Today, you share the one beauty I cannot destroy," he whispered. We'll never know Aegon's response, for the Daedric Prince's tear fell upon him and dissolved him in an instant. Only after Molag Bal's departure could the Sylvanar gather his remains. Emerald Spinner Aegon and his ivory lute were buried beneath the first Grot Oak planted by the great King Eplir, founder of the Camorran throne. But that is a tale for another time. Thank you. I'm certain everyone here knows of the great Eplir, first king of the Valenwood, founder of the Camorran dynasty. This tale is familiar to us all. Yet the tale of King Eplir's ascension is rarely told. His life began as a simple oxherd on the plains of Valen. You heard me, the plains. For back then, Tamriel was an endless sea of grass. One day, young Eplir encountered a merchant and her mother. Enchanted with the merchant's beauty, he asked how he might pursue her heart.
"When the trees choke the Valen Plains and the forest crowns you king, only then shall you hold my daughter's hand in marriage," grumbled the merchant's mother.
Eplir thought a moment, nodded, and shook the mother's hand. Then he purchased every acorn in the merchant's possession. Eplir the oxherd traveled across the Valen Plains. Where his oxen stopped to feed, he planted acorns in upturned soil. Everywhere he went, he planted. Grot oaks soon sprouted from the Valen Plains. He collected their acorns, traveled, and planted once more. Soon the Valen Plains became... The Spriggans thought Eplir a powerful wizard. Where he traveled, the grot oaks grew. They sought him out and humbled themselves before him. "O great Eplir," they cried, "how can we thank one who has given us so much?" Eplir thought but a moment. "With a crown," he said. And so King Eplir won the hand of the merchant Camorran. The affection of the Spriggans would one day form the basis of the Green Pact. But that is a tale for another time. Thank you. And now, I'd like to present the secret history of the Red Pact. Every wood elf knows of the Green Pact made with Ifri. None may harm the forest or use its bounty for personal gain. Only meat may be consumed to survive. But few wood elves know of the deal struck before. Some say with Molag Bal himself. Indeed. The Red Pact forbade the consumption of meat. It mandated the trees be cut down for homes, and fruit and vegetables alone sustain the Wood Elf people. Shocking, I know. But Molag Bal wished to keep the Wood Elves weak and sickly by making them eat the very forest around them. Such is what the God of Schemes planned. A slow death brought to the heart of Ifre's power. But the God of the Forest was no fool. Approaching the dwindling, sickly wood elves and noting their grass-stained teeth, Ifre offered them a deal. They would make a new deal, a fresh green pact, and the forest itself would always defend them. And so the Wood Elves accepted Ifrei's offer. The meat mandate defied Molag Bal's Red Pact, as did the bone and leather used to build their homes. Molag Bal's rage was great. He would repay the breaking of the Red Pact with the devouring of Gilvardel. But that is a tale for another time. Thank you. Everyone knows the tale of Gilvardel, how Molag Bal devoured an entire Wood Elf city. But few know it was the Sylvanar who kept the God of Schemes from eating all of the Valenwood. For the Sylvanar knew Molag Bal had a single weakness, the thrum of a perfectly tuned lute. So he called upon the greatest lute player in the Valenwood to send the Daedric Prince back to Cold Harbor. And so Emerald Spinner Aegon strode into the ruins of Gilvardel, ivory lute slung across his shoulders like a Nord's great sword. As the first drum rolled through the blasted town, the God of Schemes stayed his wire-wrapped fist from impaling its last dozen inhabitants. The second drum drew the father of vampires from the ravaged town. He loomed over Aegon with rapt attention. But the final strum drew forth a single tear from the Lord of Brutality's eye. "Today, you share the one beauty I cannot destroy," he whispered. We'll never know Aegon's response, for the Daedric Prince's tear fell upon him and dissolved him in an instant. Only after Molag Bal's departure could the Sylvanar gather his remains. Emerald Spinner Aegon and his ivory lute were buried beneath the first Grot Oak planted by the great King Eplir, founder of the Camorran throne. But that is a tale for another time. Thank you. I'm certain everyone here knows of the great Eplir, first king of the Valenwood, founder of the Camorran dynasty. This tale is familiar to us all. Yet the tale of King Eplir's ascension is rarely told. His life began as a simple ox herd on the plains of Valen. You heard me, the plains. For back then, Tamriel was an endless sea of grass. One day, young Eplir encountered a merchant and her mother. Enchanted with the merchant's beauty, he asked how he might pursue her heart.
"When the trees choke the Valen Plains and the forest crowns you king, only then shall you hold my daughter's hand in marriage," grumbled the merchant's mother.
Eplir thought a moment, nodded, and shook the mother's hand. Then he purchased every acorn in the merchant's possession. Eplir the oxherd traveled across the Valen Plains. Where his oxen stopped to feed, he planted acorns in upturned soil. Everywhere he went, he planted. Grot oaks soon sprouted from the Valen Plains. He collected their acorns, traveled, and planted once more. Soon the Valen Plains became the Valenwood. The Spriggans thought Eplir a powerful wizard. Where he traveled, the grot oaks grew. They sought him out and humbled themselves before him. "Oh, great Eplir," they cried. "How can we thank one who has given us so much?" Eplir thought but a moment. "With a crown," he said. And so King Eplir won the hand of the merchant Camorran. The affection of the Spriggans would one day form the basis of the... But that is a tale for another time. Thank you.
Yeah. feral beast ruined everything. I don't know how the Bosmer survive out in the wilderness like this. Like living in a war without purpose. Savages. I was part of a research expedition sent to investigate the ruins of Root Sunder, an Altma city swallowed by the jungle centuries ago. I took a short leave to retrieve supplies, and when I got back, the ruins were swarming with wild animals. What? No, they're dead. What I need is their journals. Each researcher kept notes on their finds. If I can get the journals to Eldenroot, the expedition isn't a complete waste. But I won't risk going in there. Would be safer running off a cliff. It's surprising to get help from a stranger out here. Thank you. Three journals should be enough. Knowing the horse and dogs that live out here, I mean that literally, I'm assuming at least one was eaten or defecated on. This city was part of an early colonization attempt. The jungle was infamous for being untamable, but our best minds took that as a challenge. The story goes they built a sprawling metropolis, and then it vanished, never to be seen. Honestly, who knows? Root Sunder has been a ghost story for centuries. There may have never been a real Root Sunder, but this certainly looks like a lost city. And if it will get my name in published papers, I'll swear it's Root Sunder all day.
The enemy will tremble before our might.
Snatch the bow! Quick! They've got the bow! Shoot them up! Taking! Snatch the bow! Quick! Somebody grab the bull back!
Over here.
So you didn't come to help? I'm trapped in a lower chamber. Only thing I could do was use the Welkin Stones here to project my being through these ruins. Wait for assistance. The door to my freedom won't budge. Follow the path east until you find the central chamber, marked by the large Welkin Stone growths. You'll find the door there.
Please, hurry. I'm not sure how long I can survive down here.
Thank you.
This way. Just a little bit further. It will be over soon.
Apologies, flesh thing. Theodore is long dead. We took his form to bring you here. sought Seador's attunement stone? You seek to free us? Don't waste your energy. Here you will stay. Here our roots will drink your blood. You will die as Theodore did, and we will drink you as well. Things rooted us here, so we ended them, consumed them. You seek to free us with the attunement stone? Don't bother. We don't covet freedom, we covet your flesh. And we will have it. Grind your skin bones between the rocks to take advantage. Flesh thing. Everywhere you go, we are there.
Yeah.
still seek to free us with Sidor's stone? We don't need you. It comes ages too late. And if you think we won't play you when we're free, we believe shark laughter is the way your kind is. Our mind feels pulled apart. This light reminds us of the sun. Like the songs. We are free of the Elf Thing's prison. We apologize for what we tried to do. We were mad with hunger, unable to nourish ourselves within the walls. We were not ourselves. The air feeds us now. We are the jungle. We were trapped in the City of Stone by the Elf Things, unable to drink from the sun. But you have freed us. Even now, the green calls us back to the fold. We will do what we can to atone. We thank you. All that we can do, all that we can become, now that we are free, is halting. We do not know where to begin. We would return them if we could, but in our captivity, in our desperate famine, we consumed them. They will never be forgotten. Every fiber we took from them, we remember. In your honor and theirs, we will never take from flesh things again. Return to the green. We can lose ourselves in the wind or kindle in the sun or join the rivers and wash away, but we are slow to choose. We would return them if we could, but in our captivity, in our desperate famine, we consumed them. They will never be forgotten. Every fiber we took from them, we remember. In your honor and theirs, we will never take from flesh things again.
You're back. Oh, excellent.